Hello and good morning everyone. Today we will see overfitting and underfitting in machine learning applications. So overfitting and underfitting are the two main problems that occur in machine learning and which basically degrades the performance of any machine learning model. So main goal of each machine learning model is to generalize well. Now, for example, if you are having suppose x1 here and x2 over here, and your training set is suppose something like this. So overfitting may imply that it is you have fitted like this, means you have covered all the points in the training data set. And underfitting is you have suppose something like pattern and if you fit it like this, so it will be called as underfitting of the model. You can see that it is not generalizing well. Okay, so here generalization defines the ability of machine learning model to provide a suitable output by adopting the given set of unknown inputs. It means after providing training on the data set, it can produce reliable and accurate output. Hence, the underfitting and overfitting are the two terms that need to be checked for the performance of the model and whether the model is generalizing well or not. So before understanding the overfitting and underfitting, let us understand some basic term that will help to understand this topic well. So these terms are basically signal, noise, bias, and variance. So signal, it refers to the true underlying pattern of the data that helps the machine learning model to learn from the data. And noise is unnecessary and irrelevant data that reduces the performance of the model. So signal is useful and noise is not useful. So signal will improve the performance of the model and noise will try to deviate your correct truth. Okay. So next term is bias. So it is a prediction error that is introduced in the model due to oversimplifying the machine learning algorithm, or it is the difference between the predicted value and the actual value or the truth. And the last term is variance. So if the machine learning model performs well with the training data set but does not perform well with the test data set, then variance occurs. So in the given picture, you can see that on here you are having low variance side and here you are having high variance side. Similarly, here you are having high bias and here you are having low bias. Okay. So that is the bullseye is your truth, which you are targeting basically. So this is the truth. Okay. And you can see that in the case of underfitting, these are your predicted values, which is away from the truth. So your truth is at the center, and even if all the observations are near to each other, so it is having low variance, means variation in between the observations are less, but it is far away from the target value or truth, and hence it is having high bias. On the other hand, in case of high variance and high bias, you can see that there is high variation within the observations, right? and every observation is away from the truth. So it is having high bias and high variance. Similarly, low bias and low variance. So this model is perfectly running for in the test data set as well as the training data set. So it is having low bias, it is nearer to the target value, and there is less difference in individual observations. And lastly, we have low bias and high variance. So even if the observations are nearer to the target value, but there is much difference, or all the individual observations are away from each other. That is the case of overfitting. So let us understand overfitting in detail. So overfitting occurs when our machine learning model tries to cover all the data points or more than the required data points present in the given data set. Because of this, the model starts hiding noise and inaccurate values in the data set. And all these factors reduce the efficiency and accuracy of the model. The overfitted model has low bias and high variance. We have seen that. The chances of occurrence of overfitting increases as much we provide training to our model. It means the more we train our model, more chances of occurring overfitted model. Overfitting is the main problem that occurs in supervised learning. Now suppose you are having such graph, you are having x1 over here and x2 over here. So you can see that this data point may be one of the outliers, or which is inducing the noise in your model. But since the model is overfitted, this is basically the training data set. Okay, so in training, the model is trying to cover all the points, and hence it is covering your outlier or noise also, right? Which will reduce the performance of your model. So as we can see from the graph, the model tries to cover all the data points present in the scatter plot. It may look efficient, but in reality it is not so, because the goal of the regression model is to find the best fit line. But here we have not got any best fit, so it will generate a prediction error. So even if it is covering all the points in training data set, but whenever you are testing this model with 25% data points, it will have more prediction errors. So your prediction will deviate from the target value which is required. So this is the case of overfitting. Now let us see underfitting. So underfitting occurs when our machine learning model is not able to capture the underlying trend of the data. To avoid the overfitting in the model, the fade of training data can be stopped at early stage, due to which the model may not learn enough from the training data. As a result, it may fail to find the best fit of the dominant trend in the data. So here in the example, you can see that you have started your training and you stop this. So maybe first it fitted like this, secondly it fitted like this, thirdly it fitted like this. And to avoid the risk of overfitting, you stopped your training here only. And final trend was, let's suppose, something like this, which is the best fit line. So since you have stopped at early stage, the model is underfitted. So in the case of underfitting, model is not able to learn enough from the training data, and hence it reduces the accuracy and produces unreliable predictions. an underfitted model has high bias and low variance. So we can see that the overfitting case, high variance, then underfitting case, you can see that all the points are away from your true line or best fit line, and good balance is low bias and low variance. So this is just a flow chart. So you have modeled the points, performed well on the test set. If yes, then it is a good model. And if suppose fails to perform in the test set, so perform well on training set, no, so it is underfitted, and yes, then it is overfitted. This is just a flowchart. Now let us understand this high variance, high bias with one example. So imagine we measured the weight and height of a bunch of mice and plotted this graph. So you can see that on y-axis we are having height and on x-axis we are having weight, and these are the points which we have obtained. So ideally we would know the exact mathematical formula that describes the relationship between weight and height, but in this case we do not know the formula, so we are going to use two machine learning methods to approximate this relationship. So by visual observation you can see that the trend of the data or pattern of this line is something like this. It is in the curve manner. So first thing we do is split the data into two sets. So suppose we have seated, so one for training the machine learning algorithm and one for testing them. So we as usually do, we have splitted the data into training set and testing set. So let us assume the blue dots are the training set, and let us assume the green dots are the testing set. So you can see that blue dots and green dots are here in the both pictures. Now first machine learning algorithm that we will use is a linear regression, so which will try to fit all the points in best fit line. Okay, so with nothing but the method of least squares. So in the training phase, we have considered only this blue points. Okay, so this red line indicates the best fit line. So the straight line does not have the flexibility to accurately replicate the arc in which we can see in the true relationship. The inability for a machine learning method like linear regression to capture the true relationship is called bias. So here you can see that this is the best fit line and all the points are away from this best fit line. Only this point is on the best fit line and this point. So because the straight line cannot be curved like the true relationship, it has relatively large amount of bias. So as we have seen, the bias is nothing but the difference between the predicted value and actual value. So this red line indicates the predicted value, and this is the position of actual value. So this is the bias. Now another machine learning method might fit a squiggly line to a training set. Now suppose we have fitted it like a squiggly line, okay, like shown here. Okay, because the squiggly line can handle the arc in true relationship between the weight and height, it has very little bias. So this squiggly line is covering all the points, okay, and it will have a very little bias. So we can compare how well the straight line and a squiggly line fit the training set by calculating their sum of squares. Okay, so we have seen this was the first method adopted, that is fitting in a straight line, regression line. This was the second method adopted in which the training data set were fitted into by the squiggly line. Let us understand what is bias and variance in these cases. Now, in other words, we measure the distances from the fit lines to the data, square them and add them up, which is nothing but this sum of squares. Okay, so we have calculated the difference of each point, that is distance, this distance, then this distance, and this distance, this distance, and this distance. Then after calculating the distance, okay, so basically we are calculating the error or bias from the fitted lines, then square them and add them up, summation of this, which is nothing but sum of squares. And if we calculate this in the second case, so it is near about zero, because every point is, or this squiggly line is covering all the points. Now, in the contest to see whether the straight line fits the training set better than the squiggly line, so we have, what we have done, so we have just contested between these two methods, the method of fitting the training set in a straight line and the method of fitting the training set in a squiggly line. So in the first method, we have got some distance from the true value, and in the second method, we have got no difference in this from the true value. But we also have the testing set. We have not forgotten the method or stepwise method for machine learning. So first, we have just trained the model. So in training, the squiggly line performs the best, right? We have seen here, in training, this wins. But what will happen in testing? So in testing, let us now consider all the green dots. Now let's calculate the sum of squares for the training testing set. So you can see that this was the first method of straight line, and this was the second method. So in the first phase, in training phase, the squiggly line won. Now in testing set, you can see that again this distance, we need this distance, we need this distance. So you can see that two points are there on the best fit line in testing phase. But in testing phase of squiggly line, every point is away from the best fit line. Means every point will give you the error. So in the contest to see whether the straight line fits the testing set better than the squiggly line, so in machine learning lingo, the difference in fits between data sets is called variance. Okay, so while testing, you can see that it is having variance. So it is having high variance in testing, you can see that. So this was training. The blue point, you can see that this is the training phase, which perfectly fits, and in testing set, it is not perfectly fitted. Every point is away from the best fit line. So squiggly line has low bias since it is flexible and can adapt to the curve in the relationship between weight and height. This is in case of training. But the squiggly line has high variability because it results in vastly different sums of squares for different data set, right? So it will have high variability and it will have low bias. In contrast, the straight line has relatively high bias. This is in case of training. So you can see that it is having high bias. But straight line has relatively low variance because the sum of squares are very similar for different data sets. So it is having less variance. So because the squiggly line fits the training set really well, but not the testing set, we say that squiggly line is an overfit. So means it performs well in the training while training, but it does not perform well in testing. So that's why we will call this method of squiggly line is an overfit. So I hope you have understood the basic concept, what is overfitting, what is underfitting. If you have any queries, you can send them. Okay. So have a nice day and thank you for watching.